an alternative approach to trying to create better solutions for sequential consistency, which programmers naturally might expect, is to actually relax the consistency. That is, we tell the programmers that they cannot really expect sequential consistency, but we can still tell them that they can expect something. And these relaxed consistency models that are not really sequential consistency, but they're not just like anything goes, usually differ in terms of what types of ordering do they enforce. There are really four types of ordering. There is ordering between writes to different locations. There are orderings between writes to some locations and reads of other locations. There is ordering between reads and subsequent writes in program order, between reads and other reads in program order. Sequential consistency says that basically program execution must obey all four types of ordering at all times. If we actually reorder something, we have to fix any situation where that would result in a different outcome than program order execution. So we are allowed to reorder things, but we have to always hide that from anybody being able to see it. In relaxed consistency models, some of these types of ordering need not be obeyed at all times. Usually, the first type of ordering that will not be obeyed is the read-read. So if we maintain the ordering between writes and between writes and reads, but just allow reads to proceed out of order, then we say that we have a less relaxed model than if we allow reordering of other types. So if we told the programmers that you have to write programs without assuming that reads are done in correct order, then the real question is, but how do we then write correct programs to begin with? So for example, how do we do flag synchronization if we cannot expect that after waiting on a flag, we will be able to read the new value of the data?